Hello everyone, welcome to my moto vlog channel. This is Karthik Lata tuning in. It is a good Sunday. It's too much heat from the last few days in Mumbai, but not much today. It's windy, there is sun, but not, you know, like there is no heat. So it's good day, a great Sunday. So today I'm servicing my Royal Enfield at home. I don't do much stuff, so all I do is clean her up, because even I put on the cover, the construction work going on here still settles all the dust on it. Like when I took off the cover, there was all dust on my desert storm. So I just clean up the whole bike, I wipe it the dust off, then I just, you know, use WD-40 to spray it on the nuts, some rusted parts, brakes, clutch lever, the gear lever, the clutch lever, the front brake, and the chain. Now I'm not using chain lubrication right now because I don't have one for the time being, and even if I go to Grand Tour to buy one, it's Sunday, so everything will be closed. So I'm just going to do all the stuff, and I will also take off the spark plug. It is right there. I'll take off the left spark plug. The right spark plug, I am not able to remove it because I don't have a flat screwdriver. I have the Phillips one, and this will damage the coupler of the spark plug, and I don't want to do that. So I'll just use the I'll just take off the left spark plug, because I don't need any screwdrivers to do that. I just need my hand and stuff which comes in the Royal Enfield toolkit. Now to remove the left spark plug, we'll need this bigger spark plug spanner and this jack. I always forget his name, I'm just calling it Jack for the time being. So the first thing you need to do is you need to take off this coupler. As you can see, you need to pull it out slowly, rotate it, and it's out. As you can see here, it's out. Now there is a spark plug. I kept the coupler up here somewhere. As you can see, the coupler is right here. So here is a spark plug. A spark plug is supposed to make a spark in the engine so the engine works properly and the engine starts actually. So I'm just going to take this part. Now it is smaller here and bigger hole here, so you have to put the smaller one in there. Once it is in, take this jack thing, put it inside the hole. You have to put it like this, okay, not just one hole. You have to put it right in between like this. Put it on top of it, as you can see. Now turn it anti-clockwise. Okay, now it's open. Now I'll just rotate this thing. It's a long way, to be honest, so have some patience. It will slowly come off. And the best thing about removing the left spark plug is there is lots of space here compared to the right spark plug. Like I can't even put my three fingers on the right side, but on the left side I can put my whole hand in here. So it's easy for me to remove the spark plug, and it is out, as you can see. Now my spark plug is all good actually. I don't have to do anything much with it. It's all clean and not much, like there's not much carbon settle, and it's not getting focused as usual. Guys, if you have any nice suggestion for me for a camera, please suggest me. I hope it gets focused. Now as you can see, there's a small gap between this white thing and this metal cap. So this gap always has to be, you know, proper. There is the gap mentioned in the owner's manual. So if your gap is fucked up, just pull out the owner manual and search out for this gap, or else you can just go to a service center and tell them to do the stuff. So there is a spark plug. I'll just, you know, wipe it with this cloth. I'll just, you know, clean up the stuff. Now when you are taking off the spark plug, just make sure that the engine is not warm. If it is, it will, you know, damage these rings of the spark plug. And also don't lose this ring, there's this small o-ring on it. Don't lose this ring or else you'll be fucked up. And there is some stuff in there which is I don't know, there's this dirt all over it. So just use some cloth or something to clean it off. I'll just use my finger because I can easily access it. So I'll just, as you can see, the dirt is coming off. See, all the dirt has settled in there. So just clean it with a cloth or something, and it will be good for you to use some cloth, or you can use a earbud. Okay, like you know those earbuds, you can use those earbuds to clean the clean that hole. So I'll just using this cloth right now. Yep, it's pretty clean now. So I'll just put this part back in. Make sure the ring is there. This ring is still there. Don't lose it or you will be done. Put it back in. Screw it back. Have some patience. Be slow. Now, when you will be putting that spark plug spanner on it and the jack to tighten it up, always remember, don't over tighten it. I once over tightened, not on this bike. Actually, I'm on another bike. I over tightened the spark plug, and half of the spark plug, like the part which goes inside the engine, it broke and it got stuck in the head. So, if you this that thing happens to you, it will cost you around 4,000 to $5,000 to remove that spark plug because you have to take off this head and stuff. I got it for around 200 rupees because my friend, I like the garage where I go for normal stuff. Like I own a Honda Dio, I have a Honda Dio. So for servicing where I gave it, the guy out there is my friend. So he took it out for me for like $200. So it was not a big deal. So just tighten it up with this spanner. Put back the jack. Now rotate it clockwise to tighten it. Yep, it's tight. Put back the coupler on it. Now it is going in. Just push it inside. There'll be like a crack noise. If that goes, it means your spark plug coupler is on its place. And we are good to go. Now I'll just show you the right hand side spark plug and quick procedure how to remove it, because I don't have a flat screwdriver. You need a spare flat screwdriver. So here is it. As you can see, there is a small gap between the coupler and the engine head. I don't know if it's visible. Okay, so there's a small gap. So you put your flat screwdriver inside and you just push it up so the coupler goes off. Then you take off the coupler with your finger, then you put this part on top of the spark plug, and you put this part on top of the spark plug. You put the jack on it. There goes the jack, and then you unscrew it like this, and you take off the spark plug, clean it up, put the spark plug back, and put the coupler slowly back. Now I hate the right hand side spark plug because there is not much space here as it, compared to the left one. So it's pretty tough to remove it, and even right now I don't have the flat screwdriver. I have the Phillips one with me. So if I try to pull it out with the Phillips one will just damage the coupler. So I don't want to do that. I'll clean it any other day. So that's all. Now let me just do the other servicing of the bike. So I hope you all enjoyed the video. Do like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Do like the video if you liked it. Do comment down below. If you have any queries, any video suggestion, you can comment down below. Do share this friend videos among your friends. Let them know how to remove a spark plug and stuff. I'm sorry I'm not able to remove this right spark plug once again because I don't have the flat screwdriver. I have the Phillips one. There is no flat screwdriver given in the toolkit, and I am too like I have to go all the way home on the 7th floor to bring my flat screwdriver. So I'll just showed you. So I'm sorry I was not able to remove the right spark plug. So I hope you all love the video. Do like it, do share among your friends, do comment down below if you have any queries, any question, anything. And do follow me on Instagram. I'm putting the username in the comments section, in the description box. I'm active on Instagram, so it will be fun for you to follow me. So I hope you all enjoyed the video. See you next time.